Hello everyone, my name is Brian and welcome back to another Smite request. This time around I got requested playing Chronos. I already had a game of Chronos recorded and I tried to play him a few times in other game modes, but for the playstyle I like to play him, it takes a longer time to come online with Chronos. Arena and Clash, I played in both. Arena turned out quite terribly because, in the early game Chronos isn't too powerful. He has some good abilities, can definitely contribute, but I feel like his main moment of, greatness, so to speak, comes when he is about 4 or 5 items in his build, and in that time a lot can happen, especially in Arena or Clash. If Clash is pushed up a lot, if they got some Gold Fury, some Fire Giant, or a lot of towers and a lot of kills, it's definitely a lot more difficult. Especially in Clash, I feel like steamrolling is could be quite an issue. Because if you get steamrolled or your team gets steamrolled, it is very difficult to come back from that. Anyway, so I figured I could just use this recording from this match. The enemy team is consistent out of some good warriors. Chuck, a lot of sustain in assault. Odin, his ring is just so powerful and already, closed me in. They use a lot on me, and I'm able to use my ultimate to deter a lot of the damage done. And that's one thing that's probably the most powerful about Chronos, is the fact that you can rewind, actually negate everything they've done to you in a short amount of time. And that can just turn out in your favor, like you saw here. They dumped a few Acne Bombs, Odin's Bird Bomb on me. Chuck ultimate was casted when I was casting my ultimate, so I avoided that one completely. And that way I was able to heal up, reset all my abilities, and just freely get away. That's basically what happened there. That's also one of the reasons, if you play him in an other game mode, I recommend building Warlock Sash first. And the reason for it being, of course, that if he can take more damage before he can reset with his rewind, then his rewind is a lot more effective, because you can deny more abilities. Also, when you're surrounded by a lot, you can survive long enough for your rewind to come off, because it takes some time to charge, of course. So, like I said, Chronos, pretty interesting one. Especially because he's also a very good tower killer, with his second ability activated in his fourth slot. Definitely very powerful. Agni, go in aggressive. I don't have any mana left, otherwise I could have done a lot more. And at this point, I try to backstab. Do a backstab, and that way avoid Armatross Vault. But it did not happen. Otherwise, I would have died anyway, because she still had her her mirror. And otherwise, a few autos would have done the same. And I don't think she would have ran away from that. The reason why I uploaded this is also because the enemy team has one mage, and my team has one mage as well. I'm the only mage on our team, and we have 4 physicals as well. We have 2 warriors, an assassin, Umbaz, very good in assault, don't get me wrong, and a Karin. Karin is actually also very good in assault, because his passive can heal your team up. It's not the best heal, of course, but it can heal decently. It's a bit like Cupid, Cupid's heart. Maybe Cupid Heart a bit more effective, because you can max it out early. But still very effective. Tyr does need to be a bit careful. As you can see, he takes a lot more damage. Well, not a lot more, but he takes more damage than he receives back from the minions. So not really worth it. Sometimes you just want to wait for the minions to get back a bit. Sometimes it's not even worth the risk of healing up, as you saw here. Also, since he has Sovereignty, he will heal up automatically. That's also one of the reasons why Chronos is pretty good in Assault. Assault is more of the game mode where you get to late game a lot more often. And that's because it can be quite difficult to push if you can't heal up. moved in a bit aggressive, got hit by the silence from that, from the Chalk, a bit unfortunate. It's a long silence, a long time to have no abilities. But we are able to heal tier up with two meditations, and that way we are able to pick them up as well. Barely missing the Shibulanke. Otherwise he would have died, without a doubt. As you can see, the Chalk is very low. But as long as Chalk has mana, it doesn't really matter. Because he can just heal up with his rain. But like I was saying, if you activate your 2 when the meter is on the first part of Chronos' wheel of time, then you can heal yourself up over time. And if you have more health, that heal will be more effective as well, because it's percentage healing. Which is very powerful if you, for instance, have Ethereal and a Warlock Session. Don't recommend getting both. One of both can be good enough. Definitely because, well, the reason for it, of course, being you don't want to get too much health items. You want to get a lot of damage on Chronos. But one of the two health items will help out a lot, especially if you get focused a bit more or everyone is doing more damage. And I'm just focusing the tower. I am not feeling a lot like diving as deep as my team is. They are actually picking up a few of them. As you can see, I don't put any points in my ultimate. It's a bit 50-50 if you want to do it that way or not. If you are not threatened too much or don't have to use it as much, then you don't have to put any points in your ultimate, because it will only reduce the cooldown. It won't reduce the effectiveness, only the cooldown. So by putting more points in my 2, this allows me to get more attack and movement speed sooner. And that way I can be a lot more effective. You can also elect to go for the 3 maxing out. It does a good amount of damage, but I just like the movement speed a lot more, especially because it also allows you to evade a lot easier. And as you can see, 2 salvations used, Chalk having no kill potential anymore. Bit unfortunate. Butthold and nice acne bombs. I tried to rewind, but the damage coming out was a bit too much. I thought I might have been able to rewind in time. As you can see, I pick up the Aegis. That way I can prevent some of the damage coming out. If Acne used his bombs and I use Aegis, those bombs get denied. After, I can cast my rewind, and that way he only has 1 bomb left, which is not enough to kill me. Port here, he is so dead. They still have to invest a few abilities into him, but still able to pick him up. He doesn't have an awful lot of defense, and still, when 3 of them are making work on you, then it's a pretty rough time. He does have Origin, so fully stacked as well, so that does provide a good amount of defense on both sides. And a beautiful Odin Cage traps the Shibulanke in the tower, allows him to die in that Odin Cage. But Odin does get picked up. He leaped in when our tower died, so at this point he was very vulnerable, and only me being there, I couldn't really provide enough pressure to do anything with it. As you can see here, I tried to body block the Acne into the ultimate from Wombuzz, and that way you can allow yourself, you will make sure the Acne stays in the ult longer, and that way he will take more damage as long as he sees. It's an interesting aspect you can definitely use. Body block is very powerful and sometimes a bit underestimated, because if you stand still and you don't move, you can body block a lot of people, because everyone expects you to move, always. And also, just when someone's moving in a straight line, if you put something in front of it, like for instance Loki Decoy, you can prevent a lot of it. Nice Odin Cage. I'm Thrust ult coming out, so I rewind. Unfortunately enough, I am in the tower. I use my 2 as fast as possible to just give me the additional movement speed. Stop for that buff. At this point, they are still focusing me. Beautiful Odin Cage traps the enemy Odin inside. And I dodge 1 bomb. Second one, unfortunately, I did not. Bit unfortunate. I should have dodged that one as well. Since I could have run out of direction a lot more. But at this point I'm quite fat. It's a bit expected since I'm the only magical and also the only range except for Chiron in our team. And definitely make sure I can deal a lot of damage, because they probably won't take defense a lot for me. And that has to do with the fact, of course, that I'm the only magical. They probably will still get some, because if they don't, you can see a lot of damage on the Shibulanke. 350 with my 1. Poke him down every single time. The cooldown on my 1 is so low at this point, I can just spam it, basically. But, fortunately, nice stun. But no real other follow-up on it. One downside of not leveling my ultimate. My ultimate is down at this point. And as you can see, I am trapped in that Odin cage. I don't have an awful lot going, but his team can't really help him, because they are trapped in an Odin cage as well. Like I was saying, at this point I'm putting more points in my ultimate, because I was stuck in the cage without my ultimate. If their teammates were able to rotate, then I definitely would have been in some trouble, even though I have my Aegis. Ooh, interesting aspect from Amaterasu. If she CC'd during her 2 and her 2 expires, she can fire her 2 still. So it doesn't even matter if she's silenced, rooted, knocked up, or anything. You can just... Well, that was definitely not worth it. Anyway, you can just... if you aim in the right direction while you get stunned, silenced, or whatever, and the timer on your mirror runs out, you'll be able to deal the damage, because it will still fight. Since my ult is down, I'll just go for that, maxing out my 3, allowing me to do the most damage I possibly can. Agni's really focused me at this point. Makes sense, because I am one of the strongest ranged. I'm actually at this point probably the strongest range on the team, with the Chiron needing to deal with the physical defense on the enemy side. So definitely recommended him to go for that. Nice self-meditation on the enemy team. And I can Aegis out 2 ultimates. Unfortunately enough, just barely not the Agni Bomb. And I am picked up. Actually, my entire team is picked up. And that's something that's really can be detrimental to your assault game, if everyone on your team dies at the same time, while every single one of the enemy team survives. Yes. Especially since they have some tanky characters, they have a very easy time to just go and get those towers. And if they are fast enough, even the Phoenix. At this point, we aren't far enough in the game, so they can get every single tower, every single Phoenix immediately, but they can still pressure this one. Because at this point, Chiron is the only one defending it. And he has been trapped in the cage. He is able to pick up the Odin, but the cage lasts so long that he still dies by the Shibulanke. And they are able to pick up the Phoenix. So, like I said, tanky characters. A lot of physical. Physical are very good at killing towers and Phoenixes. The fact that I am a Chronos also helps. Chronos and Sol are the only two magical that are really good at pushing those towers. You might say that Freya is good at it as well. No, not really. The amount of damage Freya can do is based on her abilities, and those don't work on the towers. So that's the reason why Freya isn't as good. I don't really get why they chase him so much. We kind of need to push up a bit, especially since they have... well, they have the fire creeps. If we don't push up the wave, it can definitely be a rough time. Because if they kill us when we are at their Phoenix, it's a lot better. As you saw here, they weren't able to pick up the Titan. But if we were at our tower when they wiped us that way, then we probably would have lost, because they didn't have to run all the way to our tower. Enemies have returned. So where you die is sometimes also very important. That's also the reason why when you're behind a lot, it's very difficult to come back, because if you're finally able to kill a lot of the enemies, then you probably won't survive all of you. And even if you do, you have to run a huge way to go and do something with it. this point, just trying to poke a bit. As you can see, a huge amount of damage on Shibalanke, and Sprint is activated. We are going in, we're going ham for that Shibalanke. I do need to be a bit careful, the Agni is still trying to focus me as well. Darkness coming out. Unfortunately enough, they aren't able to pick up anyone, so at this point that's really risky. I lost a lot of health, so I rewind, reset my health to max. Our tier is trapped in the tower. Beautiful three-man stun and picked up the Agni. So that's all the magical damage off the board for us. That will definitely help out a lot because all the warriors will have picked up physical defense without a doubt. I want to try and focus down the Phoenix because I'm the only one with the Chiron, of course, that can deal a good amount of damage to it. At this point, I think I do more damage to it than our Chiron. And that's just because Chronos at this point is online. I have 4 items, like I said, that's just a lot. I kind of want to focus it, but as you can see, a bit too risky. The two warriors are very healthy. We are as well, but still can be very risky. Amaterasu very powerful. And Chuck also doesn't really care too much. Again, axing out that last hit, but they commit and they are able to pick me up. I couldn't have done it really another way, that I would have been safer, because if I didn't Aegis out the last hit, but if I did it sooner, then I would have taken a lot more damage after my Aegis ran out. So this was the only way I could try and survive. At this point I'm getting some additional attack speed. They have some magical defense, so I am picking up the Demonic Grip. If they don't have any defenses, it's probably not worth it getting the Demonic Grip, because it only does the percentage penetration, and that's not really worth it at this point. Then you can get a cheaper item. Actually, you can get the Talcoin Ring. With the Talcoin Ring, you can get even more attack speed, 5% more, not a whole lot, but you can get more attack speed. And also gives that additional damage on your auto attacks. So that's something you can pick up if they don't have any magical defense. That way you have more attack speed, a little bit more, for less gold. At this point I am picking up a power potion. I didn't have enough to get any other items, and I felt like doing a lot of damage in the next fight will probably determine how this game will end. So sometimes you can pick it up. I don't recommend it picking up very early, especially if you don't have a lot of items yet. I am moving forward. Even though I can't see, I actually hit a lot and I'm able to pick up the Chuck almost instantly. Amaterasu ignores me with her ultimate, which is great for me. I can just freely deal my damage. And activating my two, my ability to do a huge amount of damage. With my team, we are able to pick up the three of them. At this point, they are very low on health. Sprint is activated, the chasing on, and chase is on, but they still have Amaterasu. She actually swapped out her her thing, and at this point my team is chasing her down, are able to pick her up. I did some damage to her, so it wasn't too much of an issue to pick her up after that. I hope someone will tank this, and yes, Odin will tank this, and we can pick up this Phoenix. As you can see, a lot of damage even without the backdoor protections being gone, because of the minions hitting 75 I hit with Chronos. So very powerful. And at this time we can just focus down the Titan. Only two of them left. Chuck can't really stop us at any point. And we have so much damage with our hunters and our warriors. And also Chronos. Chronos late game, very powerful. I probably would have finished off my build with Rod of Duty. If I could have fitted in my build earlier, I would have swapped out the Soul Reaver for a Rod of Tuti. But since I have enough gold for the Soul Reaver and not for Rod of Tuti, that's why I picked it, that one up. But Soul Reaver is definitely not something that's bad to pick up. As you can see, good amount of damage. And, well, a good game, to be honest. Agni also did good amount of work because he has that magical advantage if they built only physical defense. My team picked up some magical defense to deal with that. Tyr had the Urchin, and Odin picked up the Bulwark. Bulwark very powerful, very strong. Even though it's getting nerfed, it's still very powerful to pick up. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks again for the requests. I really like them a lot. It's not really forcing me, but it kind of reminds me that I haven't played some guards in a long time, and that way I can just pick them up again, try to do something with them, and maybe be surprised of the end results. So keep them coming, I really enjoy them. And as always, good luck, have fun, and I'll see you guys in the next one.